you come over here? I need to ask you something quickly, my dear. Why do you always settle for something less?
So this dog done made his way. Come and crawl up and sit under me, like always. Hey. I guess he just wants some love and attention too.
You know that, baby, you deserve it the best. Should be fighting over you. No second guessing what I'm saying. Baby, you can take this to the bank and make it sweet.
Good morning, guys. I almost tripped. I'm always almost tripping. I am so clumsy. Oh, this is actually the place that I'm going to, the supermarket. I'm in Romania. I made it yesterday. Like I said, I get vibes everywhere I go. Definitely getting good vibes from Romania. I did want to go to a tour today, but it's such a short notice that I didn't get a chance to. I'm going to just come over here. I'm getting ready to go in the supermarket, but I'm going to do this little vlog real quick before I go in. But just real quick, I made it safely, and I'm super excited about everything. So I'm getting ready to go inside and look for like a little donut or something. Not a donut, because I don't eat donuts like that, but like a little pastry or something, you know. And it's really nice. It's cool out here. I really wanted to do a tour or something like that, but it was too, a lot. I'm sorry. It's annoying. It's too late. It's such a short notice. So there was really no tours left. So I am going to do a walking tour later in probably about an hour and a half. But it's not really any tours that's available like the day of, like to see the whole town, the whole city or whatever. So apparently this is home of Dracula. I don't really keep up with all that like medieval stuff and all that type of stuff. But apparently Dracula's home is nearby, and I tried to sign up to go to that tour, but I would have had to stay another day, and I really don't want to do that. I already got my stuff booked. Got my hotel booked in Bulgaria near the beach. It's not a hostel, it's actually a real hotel, because I needed to, like, you know, I need my own bathroom for a little bit. You know, I don't mind sharing a room with people, because I haven't had any bad experiences just yet, thank God. My main bad experience that can happen is that somebody smells or something like that. I can't deal with that, but it's sharing the bathroom for me. Like, I hate sharing bathrooms. But anyways, so I'll be doing that tomorrow, but today I'm just trying to enjoy myself. Got a little walking tour. So far everything is really nice. Some bloggers be, or vloggers, they be real like they don't be caring. They just go inside. They don't care if they look crazy. Here is the grocery store. It's probably backwards. But anyways, I'm gonna go in here, get some water, and yeah, go from there.
She's a beauty queen, bad dad. You ain't nobody's number two. These men, they should be fighting over you. No second guessing what I'm saying. Baby, you can take this to the bank and make it sweet.
But this Indian man just came up to me and was like, "You work in a nightclub?" I'm like, "Really?" That's how you approach a woman. You ask her if she works in a nightclub. He was like, I can spend money on you. It's fine. And I'm like, what do I look like? Like, really? What do I look like? You just walk up to people and ask them if they work in a nightclub and I'm ready to spend money on you? I guess you thought I was a stripper or something. I don't know. I mean, I get it. I'm like the only black person around, but dang. Why I gotta be a stripper though? I don't know. But he just kept saying that he wanted to take me out to get some drinks and stuff. And I'm like, no. Dang. I'm just trying to enjoy myself. Out here downtown Romania. I'm over here taking pictures of all of these different statues because they're really cool. And ask me who they are, I have no idea. But I am doing a walk-in tour later to get to know the history of Romania. But yeah, I don't even know who these people are, but I think these statues are super cool. So I've been taking pictures of like every one of them. I think I'm going to be doing walking tours from every country I go to. I can't believe I've been missing out. It just tells you so much about the history of the country. And I know I've always said I'm not interested, but it's so like interesting. And I was also wondering why everybody drive Mercedes around here. Everybody pretty much, well, not everybody, but it's so many Mercedes and BMWs and Audis in the street. And I always wondered, like, because I saw the same thing in Moldova. And I'm like, is it cheaper over here or do people just got money like that? And she was like, basically, due to the history of the country, being a communist country, it's basically like they were withheld from getting cars. So basically kind of like now that they can actually get cars because their ruler died or whatever, they're trying to stunt on everybody. And I've been seeing it. Like I was trying to figure out why everybody had Mercedes around here. But now it makes sense. So yeah, just giving this all the history, it's kind of crazy knowing that, you know, I was in the same spot that so many people died in, and just knowing the back history of so many different places is like really cool. So yes, her name was Allie. So if you ever are in Bucharest, Romania, come and check out the walk-in tour with her. The girl was amazing. But anyways, I'm just walking through the square right now. It's kind of noisy. But it's really pretty. It's really nice.
To fetiche, ela tem fetiche, ela tem fetiche pra poder no limite.
I've almost finished, well, halfway done with Eastern Europe, and I gotta go through and finish the rest, and I can get through Central Europe and then ultimately Western Europe. And believe it or not, the reason why I came to Europe was because of France. Like, the only country I wanted to go to was France, because France. Because I wanted to practice my French. There we go. That was definitely a tongue twister for me. But anyways, I was going throughout Europe, still going throughout Europe, and just wanted to wrap up my time from Romania. Romania was a very, very fun country to be in. So the nightlife is crazy. I'm pretty sure you've seen it in one of my videos that I inserted. In one of my vlogs, we were out. I did a pub crawl for the first time. I've never done a pub crawl before. And basically, it's like a monitored or guided, like, bar hop. So basically, you get together with the group, and then you go from different clubs and bars to just check them out. And they say they give you free shots in every club, but, like, that was not, like, a real shot. That was, like, water. But anyway, or juice, rather. But nevertheless, it was still a fun experience. And that was a lot of fun, a whole lot of fun. And we started about 10 p.m. and I went home about 4:15. Well, we left the final place about a little after 4 o'clock, and I got home closer to 5 a.m. And the crazy thing about it is people were still out in enjoying themselves. All the food places were still open. And good food too. I mean, mainly kebabs, because kebabs are literally like everywhere. But they had like Subway and other places. They had actual restaurants still open. I was like, wow, Romanians really be partying. I didn't realize, because it was so, like, it's such a strict place back in the day, like such a communist place back in the day. I wouldn't think that now they, you know, party so much, but it was pretty crazy. A few things that I did learn. I learned a lot about the Roman culture because of a walking tour that I did, which was very informative. I thoroughly enjoyed it. It was so amazing. That was really awesome. I got to know more about the country and the history of it. And not too long ago, I mean, literally probably, what, 30 years or a little over 30 years ago, that was a communist place with strict rules of what you can eat, what you couldn't eat, which you could watch on TV, where you could go, who you could talk to. Like, everything was controlled by the government. And this wasn't even that long ago. I'm not talking about hundreds of years ago. I'm talking about a little over 30 years ago, which is crazy, super crazy. So yeah, that was very informative. I really enjoyed knowing the history of the country. Some of the things that I've seen is there are lots of pretzels and pastries. They eat a lot of those. you can get a pretzel or like a pastry donut type thing, like pretty much anywhere. Croissants, that's the word. So it's lots of those things there. It's big there. That's like a, you know, a dessert that they eat with like jam and cream cheese or something like that, stuffed in a pretzel or something like that. that's like a big thing for them. So I did see that everywhere. But overall, the food was pretty good. I did get some pizza one day from one of those pretzel places, and it was very good. Very good. Very good. And but I really love pizza anyways. But still, I feel like pizza in other countries are really good compared to some other places where I live in the States. But anyway, yes, that's pretty much wrapping up my time in Romania. Yeah, I had an amazing time. Got to meet some new people, of course, always. And different people from all over the world, you know, coming to Romania. Really awesome. I did get to get a shot glass because I didn't get to get one in Moldova. Couldn't find a place to get it. But I did get one in Romania. And I'm trying to see what else. I think that's it. So, yeah, I enjoyed my time. And if you're ever in the eastern part of the European map, definitely check out Romania because I had a great time and I know you will too.